History doesn't always step up and introduce itself. Usually it's glimpsed in the rearview mirror, recognized over time. But from the moment everyone arrived at the inaugural U.S. Senior Women's Open, they realized they were part of something special. Just the venue itself, Chicago Golf Club, made that statement. The week started with lots of hugs and a few tears as old friends and longtime competitive foes renewed acquaintances. Everywhere you turned, there were legends: Amy Alcott, Hollis Stacey, Betsy King, Pat Bradley. Even the first tee starter was a legend, Nancy Lopez. And at 7 a.m. on Thursday morning, when she called Joanne Carner to the tee, reading off her list of 8 USGA titles, the U.S. Senior Women's Open was underway. And all the 79-year-old Carner did was shoot her age, playing the last 5 holes one under par to do it. The support from the spectators was as impressive as the golf course itself. Chicago Golf Club proved to be a true championship test, and the fact that thousands of spectators who attended could walk the fairways with the legends of the game allowed them to enjoy the experience even more. But ultimately, it was a USGA championship. When the bell sounded Thursday morning, the giggles and grins turned to game faces, and the 66 by Laura Davies on Saturday was simply a brilliant round of golf. But in Davies, Chicago Golf Club identified a truly deserving champion. And in the U.S. Senior Women's Open, the USGA added a worthy event to its championship schedule. History was made by Chicago Golf Club in 1894 when it became one of the 5 founding members of the USGA. And history was made at Chicago Golf Club with the inaugural United States Senior Women's Open. No time needed to pass for everyone to realize that they'd been part of a special week.